In this video, we are going to find solution of non-homogeneous linear ordinary differential equation with constant coefficient. So in the previous video, we found solution of homogeneous linear differential equation. So when you get a question like this, how to identify whether the equation is a homogeneous differential equation or non-homogeneous differential equation? Suppose think that after this equal to sign, it is zero. Okay, at that time, the equation will be a homogeneous differential equation. If in the question after equal to sign, there is a function of x, it is a function of x, not a function of y. Okay. If there is a function of x after equal to sign, then the equation will be a non-homogeneous differential equation. See, here this is a function of x, e raised to 2x. Or sometimes the equation can be, a function can be sine x. Or sometime after equal to sign, the function can be cos x. Sometime the equation can be x raised to m. See, these all are functions of x. So after equal to sign, if there is a function of x, then that equation will be a non-homogeneous differential equation. Now we know we need to find solution. What is solution? Our general solution y is equal to sum of complementary function plus particular integral. Why I took y here? Because y is my dependent variable, x is independent variable. So our general solution y is equal to sum of complementary function plus particular integral. Now suppose think that after equal to sign, it is zero. That means our equation is a homogeneous differential equation. At that time, our particular integral will be also equal to zero. We don't want to find particular integral. Our solution will be only having complementary function. But in this question, after equal to sign, there is a function of x. So we need to find particular integral also. So our general solution will be a sum of complementary function plus particular integral. So first of all, we can find complementary function. How to find complementary function? For finding complementary function, we need to write auxiliary equation. How to write auxiliary equation? We need to do substitution in this equation. How to do that? We know instead of d by dx, we need to substitute capital D. Instead of d square by dx square, we will substitute capital D square. Instead of d cube by dx cube, we will substitute capital D cube. Now, if you are going to put a y here, then put y here also. If you are going to put y here, put y here also. y. Now, do the substitution. Instead of d square y by dx square, we will write capital D square y. So capital D square y plus 3 dy by dx. Instead of dy by dx, we will write capital dy minus 10y. We will write like that itself. There is no differential term here. Dy by dx like that, no differential term. So we will write 10y like that itself. So auxiliary equation means writing this equation equal to 0. We are going to find auxiliary equation, okay? Now, from this we will get y is common. See, y is common in this 3 term. So we will take y outside. Then the remaining will be d square plus 3d minus 10 equal to 0. From this, we are getting a quadratic equation, d square. So there will be two values for d. How to find that? Either you can use calculator or you can use this equation, minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. I am going to use calculator in order to save time. So click on mod button 3 time equation. This is a second degree equation. So click on 2. The quotient here A it is 1. The quotient here B it is 3. And the quotient here C it is minus 10. So we are getting the values for DS 2 and minus 5. So these are our values. So this is our root of this quadratic equation. Now, in the previous video, we discussed about finding roots. If the roots are real number and different number, see, these are real numbers. 2 and 5 are real numbers. And they are also different values. At that time, the solution is y equal to c1 e raised to m1x plus c2 e raised to m2x. This we discussed in the previous video. So therefore, our solution y will be equal to c1 e raised to m1. Instead of m1, I am writing the first value 2x plus C2 e raised to m2. m2 I am writing the second value, that is -5x. So this is my complementary function. Thus our first part is over. We found complementary function. Now we need to find particular integral. Now how to find particular integral? Okay, listen carefully. For finding particular integral, the equation it is, what is our after equal to sign, what is the term, what is our function? It is e raised to 2x. It should be multiplied by 1 by f of a. Now what is this f of a? We found our auxiliary equation. What was our auxiliary equation? It was d square minus 3d plus 3d minus 10 equal to 0. That was our auxiliary equation. So this is our f of d. F of d is d square plus 3d minus 10. This was our auxiliary equation we wrote. Now f of a means instead of d we need to substitute a. So the equation will be a square plus 3a minus 10. Now what is this a? A is the term near x. So e raised to ax. See, the coefficient near x it is a. So in this question our a value will be equal to 2. So we need to find f of 2. That will be 2 square plus 3 into 2 minus 10. 2 square it is 4 plus 3 into 2 it is 6 minus 10. So 4 minus 4, 6 minus 10 it is 4. So 4 minus 4 we will get 0. See, here we are getting 0. Our f of a we are getting as 0. So particular integral, the equation will be 1 by 0 multiplied by e raised to 2x. But look at here, 1 by 0, it is infinity. So f of a should not be equal to 0. Now what will we do if we are getting f of a as 0? Then in particular integral equation, there will be a small change. How we are writing particular integral? Our g of x, that is e raised to 2x. That we are multiplying with 1 by f of a. But if we are getting f of a 0, then we should multiply it with 1 by f dash of a. F dash of a means its derivative. And it should be also multiplied by x. Okay. So the equation, there will be a slight change. X multiplied by 1 by f dash of a into e raised to 2x. Now suppose think that if we are getting f dash of a also 0. Okay. If we are getting f dash of a also 0, then the equation will change again. The equation will become e raised to 2x multiplied by 1 by f double dash of a, second derivative, multiplied by x square. Then if f double dash of a is 0, then it will become x cube 1 by f triple dash of a e raised to 2x. Okay. So in this question we are getting f of a 0. So a particular integral equation will be e raised to 2x multiplied by 1 by f dash of a multiplied by x. Okay. Now we need to find what is f dash of a. F of a it is a square plus 3a minus 10. So f dash of a means differentiate this. A square if you are differentiating we will get 2a. Plus 3a we are differentiating we will get 3. Minus 10 is a constant. If you are differentiating we will get 0. So our f dash of a will be 2a plus 3. Now substitute. Instead of a we will substitute 2 because our a value it is 2. So we are substituting 2, we will get 2 multiplied by 2 plus 3. So 4 plus 3 we are getting 7. So our f dash of a we are getting 7. So our equation will be x multiplied by 1 by f dash of a. F dash of a we are getting as 7 into e raised to 2x. So this is our particular integral. Thus we found particular integral, it is x multiplied by 1 by 7 e raised to 2x. So what will be our general solution? General solution will be sum of complementary function and particular integral. Complementary function it is c1 e raised to 2x plus c2 e raised to minus 5x, then plus particular integral. Particular integral it is x by 7 e raised to 2x. So this is our solution to this non-homogeneous differential equation.